slightly overlapped on the inside. Probably need to just ease it out a little bit on here. Just on the inside, you can actually feel it just slightly bulging. What you could do with is, because the fabric is actually, when you turn it over, it turns over, is to actually pin this into place. Once you've laid it out absolutely evenly, pin this into place and then turn your other piece over to overlap your first piece. Now the layout of this is a little bit complicated. Once you cut into it and once you start stitching, it's self-explanatory, and basically what you have is, another name for this salwar would be the overlapped salwar, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create the full circle all the way around. This is just the cone. You can see that it looks like a cone, and what we're going to do is measure the cone absolutely evenly to take out our cutting from this. So I'm just going to focus the camera in a little bit so that you can actually see what it is that I'm doing. So you can see the tip of the cone, and then from the tip of the cone we're going to measure for the length of our samosa salwar. It's going to be similar to any other salwar. So what we have is, if we're going to use the length of the salwar as 39 or 40 inches, then we need to cut this perhaps a 35. What we'll do is we'll cut this 35 inches. So we need to measure this 35 inches going all the way across. So at the moment what we're doing is we are making our cone of absolute round. This is an absolute round cone. Really the shape of our two pieces of the salwar. That is all your excess, and this is the shape. The next thing you've got to decide is whereabouts you're going to locate your pieces or the inner seam. Now we're going to locate the inner seam on here. We've got the double fold, so what we're going to do is cut into the crotch. The length of our inside leg should be, we're going to leave that about 30 inches. At 30 inches we're going to mark for our crotch and then cut the sort of angled shape of our crotch. Now I'm going to relay a story to you. When I first started teaching on YouTube, this was probably the point at which I started. I had a class of students where we were doing a live class, and I did a video recording of the class, and the girls and I, we were all talking, just having a chat about teaching, and one of the girls said to me, "Auntie, there's a lady who teaches on YouTube, and she's nowhere as good as you, and why don't you do the videos and upload them onto YouTube?" And I said, "Don't be ridiculous, I'm not going to put them on YouTube, that's stupid." Anyway, that evening I'd gone onto the internet and I'd done the research, and I'd watched some of the videos that were available on teaching methods and techniques, And you can actually hear, if I ever get around to doing that video, it was actually on one of my old cameras. So transferring the footage from that camera onto the internet was quite difficult. And I still have that footage of that. It's so funny when we're having a bit of a laugh about all this, and we're actually talking about doing the videos on YouTube and uploading them. And here I am doing the exact same thing about a year on from when I was doing the classes a year ago. So, and believe it or not, it was a pink salwar that I was teaching one of the girls how to do, and she was making a samosa salwar, and I had actually explained to her what the salwar, what the cutting procedure was, and how she would go about making this. So if I was to open this, this is what this would look like, exactly the same as what I'd explained to you on the piece of paper. So these are your pieces, that's your two half circles, all rounded off absolutely evenly. This is part of your crotch, and that at the other side, that's at the other side, which you can't actually see from here. I pull the fabric a little bit. That at the other side is where your other point of your crotch is. So it's actually all wrapped around, and the other name for this salwar would be the wraparound salwar, because it is actually all wrapped around. The stitching of this is fairly simple, but what you're looking at here is not something that anybody will bother actually explaining to you, that this is what the samosa salwar should be. The only other thing, we've got lots of wastage on this. This is all the fabric that's been left over, and the only thing that we need out of this fabric is the belt. And what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to see if I can actually make a naya salwar out of this, which I don't think I will be able to. I wanted to make her a little samosa salwar. No, simply isn't. I suppose I could. Right, okay, from the leftover pieces, what we're going to do is we're going to make a little samosa salwar for Inaya as well. Oh, I know. Everybody else can have a samosa salwar, why can't my baby have a samosa salwar? The first versions of these salwars I did back in 1989, I think it was, and back in 89, 90, I did these salwars, and I actually did them for one of my nieces, two of my nieces. So I'm going to quickly cut into this. I was trying to locate my chalk. I'm going to unplace it. So this is like a quick one, rather than without any measurements or anything. We're just going to quickly cut this and design it for the baby. So this is something that's actually from the leftover pieces. The thing I didn't measure is you need to make sure that your circle, without actually measuring it, this has turned out to be a semicircle. The only things I need to put on these now is the actual belts, and apart from that, we're all ready.